गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास. एज इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टार्टेड रिविजन ऑफ चैप्टर वन. सो नाउ टुडे आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर वन. सो लेट्स रिवाइज इट क्विकली. सो यस्टरडे आई एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट सम यूजेस ऑफ कंप्यूटर एंड अबाउट सम बेसिक फंक्शंस ऑफ कंप्यूटर, है ना. सो आई एक्सप्लेन यू दैट अ कंप्यूटर सिस्टम वर्क्स ऑन IPO साइकिल. IPO स्टैंड्स फॉर इनपुट प्रोसेस एंड आउटपुट. सो वॉट इज इनपुट? इनपुट द डेटा एंड इंस्ट्रक्शंस विच वी एंटर यूजिंग अ कीबोर्ड और माउस इन टू अ कंप्यूटर आर कॉल्ड इनपुट. एंड एज इनपुट वी कैन एंटर एनी थिंग, ए नंबर, वर्ड, पिक्चर, साउंड, एनी थिंग वी कैन एंटर. ओके, नेक्स्ट प्रोसेसिंग इज द पार्ट वैन आफ्टर एंटरिंग डेटा द कंप्यूटर सिस्टम वर्क्स ऑन द डेटा अकॉर्डिंग टू गिवन इंस्ट्रक्शन. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड प्रोसेसिंग. सपोज यू हैव गिवन टू नंबर्स फॉर एडिंग. सो आफ्टर एंटरिंग द नंबर यूजिंग कीबोर्ड द कंप्यूटर सिस्टम विल कैलकुलेट द सम ऑफ दोज नंबर्स. सो दैट कैलकुलेशन पार्ट इज कॉल्ड द प्रोसेसिंग पार्ट. एंड वॉट इज आउटपुट? आउटपुट इज द फाइनल रिजल्ट दैट वी गेट आफ्टर प्रोसेसिंग. एंड वी कैन सी आउटपुट यूजिंग आउटपुट डिवाइसेस लाइक मॉनिटर, प्रिंटर. Okay, here they have given example of input processing and output, means they have entered some numbers like 90, 85, 69 and other, and plus means they want to sum all these numbers. So this part is called input, where they have entered the numbers, and then when the computer system calculate the sum, this is the processing part, and processing part is always hidden from us. Okay, and as the result we will get the output 502 sum. Okay, so here another example is of preparing tea. Like for preparing tea, the ingredients that we use for preparing tea, those are called input, like sugar, milk, tea leaves, hai na. And the process of making tea means boiling water and tea leaf, milk and sugar, this is called the processing part. And as the final result, we get the output, the prepared cup of tea. Okay, in another example, we can understand like the task of making a phone call. So for making any phone call, first of all we all find and dial the number. So it is called the input, means dialing the number from the mobile is called the input part. Okay, and what happened after that the mobile network will connect your dialed number to whom you have make a call, hai na? And as a output you will get output as talking to that particular person. So these all are the example of IPO process. Okay, I hope it's clear to you now. Next part of computers. So as we all know that computer is made up of many different types of parts which works different tasks. So here we have the list. Your first computer part is keyboard. Keyboard, it is an input device which is used for entering numbers and instructions into the computer. Means numbers, means any data, numbers, letters, words, anything. So we give an input using keyboard. Okay, and next is monitor. Monitor, it is an output device. It looks like a TV screen. It is also called visual display unit, VDU, and we can see the entered input as well as output on the screen. Okay, so whatever we see on a monitor, it is saved as a soft copy. Okay, so there are three types of monitor. First is CRT monitors. These types of monitors are bigger in size and they consume more power. Second type of computer monitor is LCD monitor. The full form of LCD is liquid crystal display. So these types of monitors are flat in size and they consume less power in comparison of CRT monitors. Okay, and nowadays we all use LCD monitor or LED monitor. So the third type is LED monitor. It stands for light emitting diode. So these types of monitors have better display in comparison of these two, and they are thinner and lighter weight in comparison of these two, and they use 40% less power than LCD. Okay, and it is these monitors are last longer. So these all are the three types of monitors. Okay, next, the very important part of computer is CPU, Central Processing Unit. CPU is also called the brain of computer system. It control all the parts of computer and does all the calculations, means whatever the processing part is, so it is handled by the CPU. CPU further have three parts for doing different things, like first is MU, stands for memory unit. Second is CU, stands for control unit. And third is ALU, stands for arithmetic and logic. So first, memory unit, it is used for storing information and data according to our need. If you want to save data, so you can save it, otherwise you can leave it. Okay, so the memory unit, we can store huge amount of data in the memory unit of computer system. Second is control unit. The control unit works as a traffic policeman. It control and manages all the working of all the parts of computer. So basically, a CPU perform everything, but inside the CPU, these are three parts which are used for different things, like control unit control all the task, and ALU, arithmetic and logical unit, it is used for doing arithmetic calculations and logical operations, arithmetic calculations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and other. And logical means where they need to use logic, like which number is greater, which is smaller, equal. So this is the task of ALU. Next important part of computer is mouse. Mouse is also an input device. It is used for selecting object. Object means any file, folder, anything that is stored in a computer. So for opening that particular object, we can use mouse. Mouse is a pointing device. Okay, so by pointing from the mouse, we can open any file, folder or anything, and we can make drawings using computer. Okay. Next important part is printer. So printer, it's an output device, and using printer, we can print out the information on a paper, which is called the hard copy. So if you want to print anything from your computer, so we can print it on a paper using printer. So printer, it is an output device. Okay. Now, at the last, let's discuss some points that makes computer a very powerful machine. Means why computer is better, why it is powerful. So there are some features like speed. Okay, so computer is a very fast working machine. It can do billions of jobs per second. It is very fast. And reliability means we can trust on it, because computers are quite reliable because they do not make mistakes. They always give accurate result. Third part is storage. Third function is storage. So in computers, we can store a huge amount of data, as much as we want. Next is the versatility, because computers can perform multiple tasks. These are computers are multi-purpose machine that can perform a variety of tasks in almost field. Nowadays we are using computer. It's a very versatile machine. It can be used for making animation movies. It can be used for designing. It can be used for making games. It can be used for playing games. It can be used each and every field we are using computer. So that's why it is called a versatile machine. Next part is accuracy. The computer gives us accurate result always, as we do not make any mistake in giving input, so it gives us accurate result always. Next is diligence. A computer can work for long hour without getting tired, because it's immune to boredom and tiredness. It can work for many hours without getting tired. And last point is multitasking. A computer can do many tasks at the same time. That's why it is called a multitasking machine. Okay. So all the points I have explained to you again. Now you all will revise the point at a glance part. And you all will revise the exercise and question answer part of the chapter. This is the question answer part. true and false, one word answers, and you can skip application based questions and MCQs and these full forms. And as at the last, we have the question answer part and this activity section. Okay, so revise the chapter well, because in the next class I will take your test. Okay, so prepare it well. Okay, so that's all for today. Take care of yourselves. Bye.